Tonight, the People's National Movement has won the general elections in Trinidad and Tobago. And when we win a general election, we always say, great is the PNM! Great is the PNM! Great is the PNM, and we shall prevail. Tonight, against all odds, in the most difficult situation, the PNM has once again been called to service in the government of Trinidad and Tobago. It has not been an easy task. It has not been an easy way. But the PNM has stayed the course, and once again, we have been called to provide the people of Trinidad and Tobago with the good governance that it expects from the People's National Movement. So far, as the results are in, there are one or two areas that need to be tidied up, but it appears as though we went in with 23 seats and we would come out with 22. A majority is 21. Thank you. Thank you for that support. Given the course that we have traveled, given the obstacles that we had to overcome in the period 2015 to 2020, I tonight want to say that this result confirms my faith in the people of Trinidad and Tobago, because I've always said to you that the people of Trinidad and Tobago can be trusted to do the right thing when they're called upon so to do. And tonight, you have done so today, as reflected in these results tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, I will return to office in Whitehall as the Prime Minister of Trinidad and Tobago. We have contested and contested hard, but at the end of the day, the prize was the majority of seats to form the government, and we once again have got the majority of seats. There are so many people that I could thank tonight, but I'm sure that you would not deny me the opportunity to thank my wife Sharon. Who, on many occasions, when it appears as though that I may falter, she would have held my head up, held my hand, and kept my spirit up. And for that, ladies and gentlemen, I am eternally grateful. In this party, I also would like to acknowledge all our party officers, especially those who have been out front every night in the campaign. And there is no other party officer who has been more out front on the platform with us than young Laurel Lizamalisi, chairing our proceedings, calling the public to pay attention to our platform and giving us that energy as we approach the PLM's platform. I would also like to thank Deputy Political Leader Rohan Sinanan, who is once again our campaign manager and is victorious in that way. I want to thank all the party officers, all our deputy political leaders who have been given assignments all over the country. And to say to them that the number of seats that we've won to retain the government does not in itself reflect the performance of the PLM across the country. I have been told, and I verily believe, that we have doubled our votes in Chaguanas West. And the young lady who is our standard bearer, then let me say to her and to all our other candidates who have not won seats, that you are winners. Your party has won the general election. I would like to think that in this particular election during a pandemic, where it appears as though that a number of the more senior citizens would not have participated as fully as they might have, that our young people have come to the fore, and this victory is largely as a result of the involvement of our young people. So, what does the future hold? The future in Trinidad and Tobago is bright. We have some difficult days ahead, but as dark clouds may bring showers, thunderstorm, and lightning, behind that is the bright sunshine and the warmth. So the passage of the storm is to be survived, and the good weather after is to be enjoyed. Our projections are that the next 2 years would be difficult, very difficult, but during that period, we are required to do certain things that will put us in a better position to enjoy the rest of that future which is guaranteed to us. And I would like to say to the country, the elections tonight will be over. We'll wake up tomorrow morning and these elections will be behind us. Let us go back to being one people under God, working together to build this blessed nation of Trinidad and Tobago. In this period, more than any other, let us put aside personal slights. Let us put aside personal wants and look at the national needs, especially of those persons who are least able to look after themselves. The priority of this government is to ensure that all those who call Trinidad and Tobago home, that they live here with respect and in dignity, and the people and the government will play its role. But then we would build an economy that will grow in such a way that all of us would be lifted by that rising tide of the future, where all boats would be lifted and we'll all then be able to say, Mother Trinidad and Tobago is good to all of us. But in this period, the short period ahead of us, the priority is to ensure that no one is left behind, that we make the changes that we say we will make. We have made certain commitments to the government, to the people of Trinidad and Tobago, and we intend to carry out those commitments, because tonight our platform has won and we have a mandate to do what we say we're going to do, and by God, we're going to do what we say we're going to do. And what does the future hold for me personally? This, ladies and gentlemen, could easily be my last term in politics in Trinidad and Tobago. I'm not one of those politicians who believe that when you come into office, you should go out feet first. I have places to go and people to see. But more importantly, I have a commitment to ensure that this is a period of transition in the PNM. And as the longest serving member in the parliament who will continue to serve another term, I have a duty and a responsibility during this term to fashion the PNM's future by ensuring that our young people are developed in such a way that when I'm no longer in this position to announce an election victory, that the country will not be deprived of the leadership it deserves. This is my period to ensure that the young people that I have been monitoring, that I have been mentoring, that they move into greater responsibility. This is that period. So Trinidad and Tobago, this is a period of transition, but I would not shirk my responsibility to the people of Trinidad and Tobago who have elected me as Prime Minister for this 5-year period. Ordinarily, we would be here in our thousands to celebrate this victory, but tonight is a different night. This election took place in a different time. It took place during a pandemic, When I finish speaking to you, I put on a mask. And you're wearing your mask. But we've conducted an election. And I must say that I monitored all day today. And from the reports that I have had, as a people, we have conducted ourselves properly during a pandemic, and the election is now out of the way. Safely out of the way. But let us not forget, ladies and gentlemen of Trinidad and Tobago, children as well, we are trying to survive in a pandemic. So we have no license to behave as though we can ignore the exhortations of the health department. I will be in Whitehall soon after I am sworn in, and I will continue to provide this country with stable and sober leadership. Let us feel proud as a people that our democracy has worked. We've selected our leaders peacefully and quietly, and we will put our shoulders to the wheel, and we'll overcome whatever difficulty stands in our way. We are one people, Trinidad and Tobago, one people. We have one government, and we will so conduct ourselves in the parliament. Time is of the essence. I promise you, young people, that during this period, we will digitize this country, and you will see that reflected in the appointments to the cabinet. I promise you, young people, that we will take you into training programs and expand our economy and agriculture. You will see that in the cabinet and in the budget. As I leave you now, I go to put a cabinet together. And soon after that, we begin to put a budget in place. Because once again, soon after we're elected to government in the country, we have to go straight into preparing a budget. That is our first assignment. And I ask you to be patient. I ask you to be supportive. I ask you to leave behind all the aggravations of the elections. Leave that baggage behind. Let us look ahead, firm in the gaze that we are looking at our future, a future which all of us have committed to, and a future which says to us that we ought to have boundless faith in our destiny. That destiny is largely in our hands. So I want to thank all those of you who are PNM standard bearers, all 40 of you. It has been a pleasure, it has been an honor to lead you into battle and to have held on to government for another 5-year term. I say to all of you PNM standard bearers, thank you for that support. But I also want to say to you again, as I said to you in 2015, the government would have come from the PNM. But it's not a government for only the PNM. It's the government of Trinidad and Tobago. So once again, this venerable party has come to service when called by the people of Trinidad and Tobago. Thank you, thank you. Members of the media, let us start with a clean slate. Many of you have been naughty, sometimes accidentally. But I must say, I do enjoy my interactions with the media. There's only one thing I really, really hate, is when you quote me saying things I didn't say. So if you promise me that, we're going to be friends. But you've done a really good job, and I've really observed some of you. Some of the young people have been around doing really good work. You've done a really good job during the COVID period when we came out there and every day talking to the public, and it was you who were there. And whenever we have our press conferences, you're there. And by and large, you've carried this coverage very well. And I want to thank you all for that. And I want to ask you to continue to be responsible. Just be responsible. Let the agendas emerge. But your agenda of the fourth estate is to ensure that when it comes from the media, the average person can say, I read it in the papers, and therefore it's true. But this is the age of fake news, and I know how difficult it is in your job to ensure that your news is the correct news. But Trinidad and Tobago is a wonderful place, a bountiful place. This is a period of difficulty. But let me end on this note, that tough times don't last forever, but tough people do. Trinidad and Tobago, thank you very much. And under God's blessings, we will continue to paddle our canoe in this swift current. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you.